All kids out of the pool for adult swim. All kids out.
Looky at us, we're three sailors on shore leave.
Yeah-a-rooney.
Arr, feels good to be off that rusty boat, eh, you stinking vermin?
Yes, sir.
What do you want to do for fun, mateys?
I'd like to do some sketches of birdlings.
And I wouldn't mind checking out some antique furniture shops.
That'd be fun.
Yeah.
What a couple of livered lilied sissies. I got a better idea what we can do. Arr, let's punch out some scum suckers and get drunk and pee out the window. And then let's seduce women. Lots of women.
What window?
How's about I beat the piss out of you? Arr, take that.
Can I talk to you for a second, Melissa?
Uh-huh.
Now, you know you'll always be my little baby girl, right?
Yeah.
No matter what.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that I'm afraid I'm going to blink and you'll be a man before I know it.
Dad.
Let me ask you this. First of all, great movie. Who did your stunts?
Me.
Did you remember to wear a cup?
Dad.
Hey, do you have any friends besides Brendan and Jason?
I don't know.
Do you have any friends that are girls?
No.
Any friends that are girls about my age? I'm kidding. Look, I guess what I'm saying is that I used to be like you. I went through a whole gender-bending phase.
Dad!
Just hear me out, please.
Okay.
Totally forgot what I was about to say.
Dad!
Oh, about the gender-bending thing, right. No, it's nothing to be ashamed of. In fact, I think it's a healthy thing. For me, it was great, you know, to get in touch with both sides of who you are. Remember when we had our bird tested for gender?
Mm-hmm.
And we couldn't tell the gender of the vet?
Dad, what are you trying to say?
Honey, have you heard of the Fairy Princess as a group?
Yeah, I think some of the girls in school are members.
I did some reading and it seems like fun. You know, hanging out with other kids and doing things after school.
I think you're too old for it.
Not me, honey, for you. Any interest?
That's all right.
Well, let me put it to you another way. I've signed you up and now you are a fairy princess.
I am?
Yep. So you're going to need to turn in your jockstrap and your cup.
Both?
Melissa, I can't believe you're a fairy princess.
Yeah, so I'm going to have to miss some practice and probably a few games.
So the whole weekend is off for the movie, too?
Yeah, sorry, Brendan.
Well, Melissa, I hope you know this looks bad. I mean, you're letting the team down while you hang out with a bunch of whiny babies in stupid uniforms.
It's supposed to be fun.
Fun?
Yeah.
Bunch of girls playing hopscotch, skipping rope. Well, you may have a point.
Real
point is you're a disappointment to the team, Melissa.
Coach, it's just a club for girls.
Well, why don't you join then, Brendan?
Because I'm not a girl.
Well, that's a laugh.
Hey, leave him alone, Coach.
Why? What are you going to do, fairy princess? Fly up and sprinkle dust on me? Turn me into a little kitty cat? Can you do that?
Not yet.
Well, you have to carry a wand?
I gotta go. I'll see you later, Brendan.
Bye-bye.
Well, you tell the fairy princesses I said hi, Melissa.
I will.
How about that, Brendan? How about that? Huh?
Yeah.
Let me tell you something about women, Brendan.
Yeah.
Women are insane. They're insane, all right? You get them together in a group and they go insane. Or they turn into animals.
Damn.
And they eat their own.
Huh.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Nope.
Brendan, we still on for the weekend?
Fenton, in regards to what?
You spending the weekend at my house. Making video films, hanging out. You said you'd get back to me.
Oh, I guess I'm still mulling it over.
Oh, how much time do you need? I mean, come on already.
Fenton, I'm just trying to piece together what I have going on this weekend. Me and Melissa...
Melissa's gone all weekend!
You know that.
Yeah, Brendan!
Oh, well...
Brendan, if you don't want to spend the weekend with me, just tell me.
It's not that. It's just that we have no real reason to not sleep at our own homes.
We have no reason? How about this? We're friends!
Oh.
Brendan, this is a one-time offer, okay? Only good for this weekend.
I'll keep that in mind.
You and me! Hanging out! Video films! Having fun, horsing around!
I guess I get the picture.
I'm gonna let you think about it.
Okay.
You think about it, huh, Brendan? Huh?
Yup.
Hey, who am I? Yup.
I don't know. Me?
Yup.
I'm home!
I don't see why Brendan can't spend the weekend with Fenton.
No, Mom, no.
Hi, sweetie.
No, what are you doing?
Actually, he usually sleeps in his underpants, but I can make sure he brings his pajamas with little feet things.
Mom, no, no, absolutely not.
I'm sorry? Yeah,
no.
Okay.
Well,
no, that
sounds
great.
No!
Okay, all right.
No.
See you later.
No.
Bye-bye.
Oh, no.
Hi, honey, how was your day?
No, Mom, no, I can't believe you.
You'll never guess who that was.
All right, walkie-talkie test. Let's see if these babies work.
Can anybody hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Can anybody hear me? I repeat, hear me.
Yes.
Yes.
Melissa, do you think Jason knows to take his thumb off the button so he can hear us? Whoops. Now can you hear me?
Can anybody hear me?
Yes, yes. Who said that?
Me.
Okay, who's that?
Okay, can anybody hear me?
No. I mean, yes.
Okay, guys, we need to keep in touch this weekend, so we have to learn to use these things, all right? Whoops. Hello? Can you hear me now?
Yes. Whoops. Yes. Over.
Okay, I'm talking now. Can you guys hear me?
Is that you, Brenda?
No, it's Melissa.
How are you?
Fine, Howard, but I'm not Melissa.
Oh, who is this?
It's Brendan.
Oh, hey, Brendan, what's up? I was just asking about you about a second ago.
Who's talking right now?
I think it's Melissa.
No, I think it's Jason.
I think it's Brendan.
No, it's Melissa.
No, it's Jason.
Now it's Brendan.
Yes.
What?
Look, guys, we have to keep in touch this weekend because Melissa's at the Fairy Princess's and I'm staying at Fenton's. So leave the walkie-talkies on. Leave them on. Whoops. Can you guys hear me now?
We can hear you, Melissa.
Fairy princesses?
Hello, lady!
I want you to meet our newest member and a very pretty young girl.
Hello, Melissa!
Hello, everybody.
Hello, Melissa!
Hi.
Hello, Melissa!
Yep.
Now, hey, who wants to have some fun?
Oh, yay!
Yay.
Doctor, please help me. I have no feeling on any parts of my body but my face.
I'm not the doctor.
Yes, you are the doctor.
No, not anymore. Now I'm a guy with superhuman strength. And I've come to carry you, my paralyzed friend. Best friend! My paralyzed best friend! Upsy-daisy!
Okay, don't touch.
Well,
don't.
I have superhuman strength, and I'm really handsome. More handsome than you.
Okay, cut. Why does your character exactly have to be more handsome than me?
I can also fly!
Okay, well, okay, but what happened to the doctor finding the cure scenario?
It sucked.
Fine. Okay. Ready?
Yes, but I'm also the president, and I'm really tall.
Oh, how tall?
6'4".
6'4".
6'5".
Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Action. Hi.
Hi!
Cut. Not bad.
It's good!
You know, I have to say it's kind of nice just hanging out with a neighbor, having a cup of coffee, no kids around.
Sure is.
Hey, let me ask you something, Paula. Do you ever get worried about Brendan growing up without a male role model in his life?
Nah.
You know, it's funny how kids are affected in ways that are so subtle that we don't even know.
How do you know that?
I don't know. We don't know.
Okay. You know. Slow down there, Eric.
I don't know. You know what? It's the coffee.
Yeah.
I haven't had coffee like this since the 60s.
Mom! Me and Brendan made a movie and I'm the hero. It's really good. We're going to show it right after dinner. Right, Brendan?
Oh, no, it's not ready. It's not very good. Yeah.
Not good? Are you kidding me? It's great. Mom, I'm the hero. I look really good on video film, right, Bren?
Can you pass the, I guess I'm not saying anything. Never mind.
Do you like your food, Brendan?
Yes. Yes, I do.
You sure don't look like you like it. You haven't really even touched anything. I don't think he likes it, Mom.
I like it. See? What exactly do you call this dish?
Rice.
Yeah, but what's the flavoring?
It's rice flavored.
Well, I guess that's what I thought I was tasting. Yep.
Settle down, my little fairy princesses. It's time for the fairy sales princess meeting.
Sales meeting?
Yes, my little fairy princess.
But I don't...
Sit back and relax, everyone. Please direct your attention to the monitor.
Welcome, my little fairy princesses, to the FPC, the Fairy Princess Corporation. If you're watching this, and congratulations, you are a fairy princess. That means that you are pretty and little and sweet. But that also means that you're responsible for productivity.
What the crap?
Sales productivity. I know what you're saying. Well, I'll tell you what you'll be selling. The FPC collection, including the FPC Fairy Hair Princess Kit, the Fairy Brella, a lightweight, fully functional rain brella, and finally, our big seller, the FPC Fairy Cloth, a beautiful multicolored tablecloth.
Well, girls, are we getting excited yet? Yeah! Good, because tomorrow you're going out to your local mall to show your little fairy hearts out. Yeah!
And remember, plainclothes FPC members will be phantom shopping and monitoring your productivity. And we stand by our three strikes, you're out bad sales punishment technique. Talk the talk, little fairies, and good luck! Goodbye!
Okay, my turn, I roll. I get a 9.
I think you got a 7, Fenton.
Now I'll never know. I get a 9, which means I win again.
Big surprise.
That's 14 games to 0. I've won, Brendan. I'm really beating you.
Well, at least you don't gloat.
Let's play again.
Let's not. Let's watch TV or something.
Yeah, right. No TV, Mom says.
What?
Okay, let's do something fun with our hair.
What?
Boys, it's 6:30. Time for bed.
What?
Come on, Brendan. Let's put on our pajamas.
What?
Melissa, before we go out and sell tomorrow, we're going to work on a couple sales exercises.
Okay.
All right, sell me the FPC fairy cloth.
Okay. Would you like to buy an FPC fairy cloth?
No, I wouldn't.
Okay.
No, Melissa, we don't take no for an answer, all right? Don't let me say no. Understand? Let's try again.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes. Excuse me, would you like to buy a fairy cloth?
No.
Please?
Absolutely not.
Why not?
Because I don't like them, and I don't need them, and I don't have time for your nonsense. Now leave me alone.
Okay.
No, Melissa.
Yeah.
You took no for an answer. That's twice you did that. That was wrong.
But you told me to leave you alone.
Never listen to someone when they tell you to leave them alone. Understand?
I guess so.
Let's try again.
Would you like to buy a fairy cloth?
No, go away. I don't like you very much.
But a fairy cloth would make a good gift for a loved one.
Well, I don't have any loved ones. I live alone.
You do?
Yes.
But what about your family?
They're dead.
I'm sorry.
Well, it's not your fault. People die.
I know, but I shouldn't have brought it up.
No. It's nice that you brought it up.
Would a fairy cloth make you feel better?
No. You leave me alone or I'll call the police, you little goblin.
Okay.
No, Melissa. You took no for an answer.
But you said you were going to call the police.
So?
So it's the police.
So what's the police going to do? Arrest you?
I don't know.
How old are you?
8.
Well, they're not going to touch you. Let's try it again, and where's the smile? I want the smile. There it is.
Would you like
no.
to buy...
No!
Guys, can you hear me? They're making me suck suck. I don't want to do it.
They're making me make
video
films. He's bad. He's bad. The food is bad.
This is Jason. I can't come to the walkie-talkie right now. If you'd like to leave a message, please do so after all the beeps.
Jason?
Beep. Jason?
Got enough room?
I don't know.
It's extra warmy warm in here, isn't it?
I don't know.
Bren? Did you mean it when you said I look good on video film?
I have no recollection of saying that. Are these plastic sheets?
Yes, because I think I have a really good look, don't you?
Sure. Hey, can we turn these lights off or dim them? Because I think I'm gonna...
No!
Okay.
Lights on.
Well, I tried.
Lower your voice, Brendan! We don't want to get in trouble!
Lower my voice? I'm hardly even...
Quiet! Brendan?
Yeah.
You know what's great?
No.
You and me.
Oh.
Right now.
Yeah.
Right here. And this is just the beginning. I think we're going to be friends for a long time. Forever! I mean, we understand the little things like video films and board games and video films and boy, oh, I. Good morning! Time to wake up!
No.
Wake up, Brendan!
No.
Cock-a-doodle-doo! Time to do the chores.
Why are you doing this to me?
Huh?
What time is it?
It's 5:30.
Wake up, fairy princesses! Wake up! Today we sell! Get up, you little fairy princesses! Get up before I get you up!
Excuse me, ma'am. Sir, would you like to buy a fairy cloth, please? Miss, would you like to buy a fairy Please, somebody buy one of these things. Somebody help me out. Buy a fairy cloth. Please, help
me. Melissa?
Coach?
What are you wearing?
It's my uniform.
Yikes. What are you doing here? Shouldn't be in a mall by yourself in that outfit.
I'm not alone.
No. What are you talking about?
There are people watching me. Please, buy something.
What kind of people?
Excuse me, sir. Would you like to buy a fairy cloth?
You talking to me?
Please buy something, Coach.
I'm not going to play your game, Melissa. But I'll tell you something. I told you so. All right? Chalk that up in the I told you so department.
But, Coach, I never wanted to do this.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Cry me a river. I was right and you were wrong. Now you're miserable and that's good. Why am I so satisfied about that?
Coach, please.
What do you want me to do, Melissa, huh? You want me to come in and buy all your stupid fairy princess merchandise? Is that what you want?
Yeah, it would really help me out.
What do you got?
Umbrellas and fairy princess cloths.
Give me those wings.
I can't. I'm not allowed to take them off. Coach, please, I'll get in trouble.
So what? Coach wants to wear them. Coach wants to fly away.
Coach, are you drunk?
Yeah, that's why I came to the mall.
Oh, did we have a game today?
Oh, yeah, we lost. Thanks a lot, by the way.
Coach, my dad signed me up, not me.
Oh, pardon me if I don't believe you, Melissa. Now, you made your bed. Now, you go sleep on it.
You mean sleep in it?
Sleep on it, Melissa. And you tell the fairies I said go to hell.
Coach,
where
please.
They belong!
Coach.
Hey, where's the food court?
Top floor.
I gotta get some spare ribs in me.
Jason, come in, Jason.
This is Jason, over.
Jason, it's Melissa. I need help, over.
Roger that, Melissa. I'm your man.
Brandon, it sure is raining, huh?
Shut up.
I think we're almost finished. Too bad. Oh boy, Rice again. You're the dirty villain and I'm the hero and you suck.
Yep.
And you're really stupid and I'm really smart, okay?
Okay, sounds good.
And you're fat and have bad skin and I'm thin and have small pores.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see.
And you're wonderful.
Yeah, and you're horrible.
Horrible. Your sales today were horrible.
I know.
Did you even try, Melissa?
I don't know.
Well, I'll tell you, compared to the other fairy princesses, you're not very good.
Okay.
And I want us to work on this together, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I want us to work on this all night if we have to. We have to pinpoint your problem because your sales are unacceptable.
What time is it?
It's 6:30.
6:30? Time for bed, boys. And get lots of rest because tomorrow we finish what we didn't finish today. Nighty-night.
Good night, Mommy. Brandon, say nighty-night to Mommy.
Yeah. See ya.
No. Nighty-night.
Good night.
No. Nighty-night!
Nighty-night.
Sleep well and sleep tight. Say sleep tight.
Sleep
tight. Say it!
Sleep tight.
Say you too.
You too.
Okay, I will.
I'm making this tape in the closet in the hallway where they can't hear me. I'm making this tape so that when they find me, they'll know how I died. I hate this place. I hate Fenton. I hate his mother. I haven't eaten. I haven't slept. I worked all day in the Muley's yard. I fear that these are my last days. I had a good life, though. I should be thankful. That's all for now. I'm going to the bathroom.
Okay, Melissa, you're not trying hard enough to sell me. Sell me like your little life depended on it, because one day it will. Now go.
Right now, I realize I have to go to the bathroom. Will you excuse me, please?
Make it quick.
What are you doing to my mother, Brandon?
I wouldn't
do you.
Oh.
hell are you kids doing here?
Thanks for the escape plan, Jason.
No problemo, baby.
I can't stop thinking about it, Coach. I think I just went through a life-changing event.
I told you, Brendan, seeing a naked woman is an amazing thing.
Yeah,
but it was Fenton's mom.
So?
So?
So she's... who cares?
Look, I'm just happy everybody's safe. Safety is the most important thing in the world.
Brendan, make this kid stop talking through that thing before I break it.
Well, Brendan, make this guy kiss my ass and then put on some deodorant because of the stink coming from him.
Over now.
Hey, I am so sorry about the whole fairy princess thing, and I hope that someday you can forgive me.
Well, someday I'll probably be able to, but for now you're on probation.
You know, I feel particularly guilty about questioning your masculinity.
The funny thing is that Brendan is the most positive female influence in my life. I mean, look at how he runs.
You are in so much trouble with me that I can't even say a sentence with words that can sound correctly good.
I'm sorry. Hey, at least you got to see a naked lady.
Yeah. And I guess Fenton's a little more popular because of it, too. Look.
Fenton, can we spend the night at your mom's house?
Yeah, Fenton, we're your friends now, so let us spend the night there.
Yeah, maybe we'll see something neater, like a naked person.
Or naked. Yeah, you said that already.
I did.
Yeah, we want a naked sleepover.
Maybe we'll see your naked mom, Fenton.
Shut up and leave me alone.
Too many players on the field. Hey, where's your coach?
Let's see what we got here. Holy sh**.
Hello, domain name registry.
I'd like to register a domain name, please.
Okay, well, I put my list out right here. Let's see what you got.
Fentonsnakedmom.com.
Okay, so far, I look right here. It says that name is already took.
That's taken? Fentonsnakedmom.
Yeah. Sorry, buddy, you gotta come up with something else.
How about middleagednakedmom.com?
Okay, let me tell you, look, that. No, that's taken. You have to go .org.
.com is taken. I gotta go.
Yeah, let me look.
Oh, yeah. KFC Crispy Strips, 100% chicken breast, hand floured and freshly prepared in the kitchen. So they're crispy on the outside, tender on the inside. And new at KFC, Hidden Valley Original Ranch. To step up from chicken strips to crispy strips, you got a KFC What's Cooking.
Look at the size of those M&Ms.
They're ogre-sized, just like him.
That's a lot of chocolate. Must be under a magic spell.
So what do we do?
Well, when it comes to breaking spells, usually somebody's got to kiss somebody.
That is not going to happen.
Ogre-sized M&Ms. Get them while they're big.
Ooh, look at that big yellow M&Ms over there.
That's the sun.
Yeah, I knew that.
How do you describe a playmaker?
How do you describe a playmaker?
Guy who's clutch, who makes the big time plays.
In big games, baby.
He pulls guys.
Knocks guys. Rips guys out of their shoes.
Bang, bang. Boom.
The playmaker makes the catch.
Over the middle.
He better not come across that middle.
Edge of your seat to your feet.
He gets the stadium to go off.
Yeah, yeah. And the guy that I'm talking about?
He's an offensive guy.
He's a defensive guy.
Hey, Ray, talk to me on Monday.
What'd you say, Michael?
Offense, baby.
Playmaker?
He's a tank.
Sports car.
A semi.
He rips it away when it matters.
Never, ever coughs it up.
He makes the big pass.
He bats it away.
He makes the big run.
Big catch.
The big hit.
He makes the big kick.
What?
Kickers will speak when spoken to.
Introducing Playmaker Control, only in Madden NFL 2004, the official game of Playmakers. Rated E for everyone. EA Sports. It's in the game.
Dude, you didn't have to wait. I told you I'd meet you inside.
I know. I didn't want to go in alone.
Spaghetti? What kind of breakfast is that?
It's dinner.
But your clock on the wall said it was 9 a.m.
There's no clock on the wall.
Sure there is, the one that's melted.
That's a Salvador Dali painting, you moron.
Then what was the ringing noise we heard?
I don't know. The telephone?
Then how come when I tried to answer it, all I heard was ticking?
Because that was the clock.
But you just said the clock was a painting.
Mmm, spaghetti! My daddy calls it eating string.
This place is awesome. I can't believe all this food is free.
No doubt. It's like we're in prison or something.
I don't think there's any place to sit.
Sure there is. We can sit right there.
But we don't even know those guys.
This is how you make friends, Del. Watch and learn. What's up, dudes? You guys go to college, too? We go to barter.
We all go to barter.
Sweet. I'm Sanford. The lady from our high school said we'd fit in at this college. Then she got arrested for dating a fifth grader.
Did she go to jail?
There was a trial. And he tells it better.
I don't know if she went to jail, but it would be cool to be that little kid.
Aren't you concerned about hardened arteries?
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna have the hardest damn arteries. They're gonna kick ass.
Oh, God. Unbelievable.
Hey, I just heard a funny joke. What's the capital of Thailand?
Do you mind if I...
Bangkok! That's a classic. Dude, you walked right into that one. Nice meeting you, dudes.
Wow. You're like Mr. Popular or something.
Aw, my spaghetti's dirty.
Toward the end of the Cold War, Gorbachev had implemented his policies of perestroika and glasnost, which marked a period of openness between the two superpowers.
Uh-oh! Jump on the back of this shark!
Now, who can tell me what led to the breakup of the Soviet Union? Rebecca?
Socialism could no longer sustain itself in the face of global market forces.
Yes, that's one of the reasons. Anyone else? Sanford.
What was the question?
Can you tell us why the Soviet Union broke up?
Their drummer died?
Nice job, Einstein.
You know the amazing part? I was just guessing.
Man, am I hungry. At least you get to the cafeteria before they run out of bread again. My hands are still blistered from that grilled cheese.
I can't go, dude. I got switched to a new phys ed class. Hit one crybaby with a folding chair and suddenly I'm the guy who doesn't know how to wrestle.
But then, who am I gonna go to lunch with?
I don't know. I had to bring this beef jerky to tide me over. Oh, what a ripoff! That guy sold me a pencil! Well, wouldn't be the first time I ate a number two. The last time I won a dollar.
Come on, Del. Be brave. What's the worst that could happen?
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Special Ed Phys Ed.
Wait a second. This is Special Ed?
Professor, Larry's bag came off again.
I'm gonna kick so much ass here, it's sick.
Joe, you wanna go to the cafeteria with me?
Interesting. No one's ever asked me that before. But no, I'll be transferring out of here soon. So although it was nice of you to ask, any social gesture on my part would be pointless.
What was the question?
Dude, I'm open! Pass it here!
thanks for letting me eat here, Todd.
Sure. I used to be afraid of the cafeteria, too. I didn't have any friends when I was a freshman, but now that I'm an RA, I have 40 friends. Actually, if you count my figurines, it's more like 56. Then there's my Star Wars pillowcase. 62. Now, I didn't used to count Darth Vader, but then in the third movie... Oh, and there's the creak in the door, which is kind of like an old friend. I call it Dorson's Creek.
Come on, Del. Be outgoing. Be like Sanford. Is this seat open?
Sure thing, buddy. The whole table's open. We were just leaving.
What?
Is someone sitting here?
No, have...
Great! We need these two chairs.
Oh, this is a disaster.
Hiya, stranger. Mind if we join you?
No, I mean, yes. Sure. Do you guys go to college, too?
Of course we do, silly bones.
Hey, aren't you the one who's always hanging around that other guy? You know, the big guy?
Oh, yeah, that's Sanford. Everyone knows Sanford. He's like Mr. Popular.
That guy's a douchebag.
What?
Yeah, he is. I don't like to use that word, but he is a douchebag.
Yeah, he is.
Total douchebag. He's a douchebag. Oh, ooh, I didn't see they had tacos.
Del, check it out! Crippled Steve left his wheelchair outside the showers.
He probably needs that.
Hey, look at me! I'm a quadruplet! What's wrong with you? This is hilarious! This is even better than the last time I stole a wheelchair.
I guess so.
Hey, Del. What's going on?
I'm just watching Sanford roll up and down the hallway. What are you doing?
I'm headed over to the student newspaper. We're starting layout tonight. Wanna come?
Get out of my parking spot, you bastards!
Okay.
Hey, where are you guys going? Wait up!
Oh my God! Sanford's a paralegal!
Oh, we have a visitor. Welcome, welcome.
Well, I'm Del. You probably don't remember me. We ate lunch together a few hours ago.
Of course we remember you, goofy Gus.
I can't believe you guys put together a whole newspaper. How do you come up with all those ideas?
It's a team effort. Right now we're helping Barry come up with a headline about death on campus.
Death on campus?
What did you say?
Death on campus. I was just...
Oh my God, that's brilliant. Death on campus. That one had Barry stumped for days.
I was not stumped. Don't tell him I was stumped.
Wow, you're good.
He can't come up with headlines. Maybe after he's worked on the school newspaper for 3 years, or won a student Pulitzer for his daring expose on library hours.
Oh, Barry, take a chill pill.
We have a library?
Oh my God, that sounds satirical.
It's a wry commentary on how the library is almost never open. Great job, Delzer. Oh my God, I just called him Delzer. That's so funny. Isn't that funny?
Who's Delzer?
That's like the coolest nickname. I had a nickname once in high school. They called me Pillow Butt.
That's so you!
I know.
Hey, who was that president with the beard and the top hat?
Abraham Lincoln.
No, this guy gave a really important speech about slavery or something.
It's Lincoln, you moron. Lincoln delivered the Gettysburg Address.
You're thinking of someone else. The guy I'm talking about was involved in a big war.
The Civil War. How stupid
Uncle
can you...
Uncle Sam?
That's it! Uncle Sam! Thanks, man.
No problem. I'm kind of a history buff.
All right, that's enough education for one day. Let's go eat.
I can't. My new friends invited me to go see a feminist comedian.
You what?
Why don't you come with us? You're always saying we should try new things, go on adventures, drive around in a van and solve mysteries.
That's different. Those are all my ideas. This is your idea, and that sounds pretty selfish to me. You go ahead, though. Maybe I'll meet you there.
Abraham Lincoln, does this refresh your memory?
Dude, are you trying to bribe me? Because I can't be bought. All right. What do I have to eat?
I don't know. I think you guys would like Sanford.
Maybe we were thinking of a different person. This guy was gross.
And weird looking.
No, that sounds like him. But he's a good guy. We met in high school. We used to get beat up together by the same gang.
In high school, I was on the yearbook staff.
Well, that was the gang.
Shh! You guys are making too much racket. Can't hear my book on tape. Now I have to rewind.
Are you there, God? It's me, Margaret.
Where's that voice coming from?
Oh, Delzer.
And for extra credit, I want you to translate this ancient Greek treatise on human anatomy into Latin.
Sweet.
Somebody congratulate me. I just gave birth to a 6-pound, 4-ounce baby boy. Don't you want to know what I named him?
No.
Brownie. Brownie von Turdmeister III. And he's got his father's hair.
That's almost as funny as yesterday's Brownie von Turdmeister II.
Yeah, but this is funny for different reasons. Del would have thought it was funny.
Yeah, well, Del's an imbecile.
Nah, it was probably just over your head. I'm bored. Oh my God, is Joe wearing a dress in that picture? Oh, this is too good to keep to myself. Del! Oh, crap! Hey, Todd, check out this picture of Joe in a dress!
Oh, I get it. Todd was born with both male and female reproductive organs. Ha ha
ha. You know how on airplanes they give you that little bag of peanuts? What I can't figure out is how come men are Neanderthals who have been oppressing women since the dawn of time?
Wow, he's great.
Look at this guy in the front row. He's like, not me, not me. This guy's got rapist written all over him.
You don't got me good. Of course, I was asking for it. Sitting in the front row.
Oh, my God. What kind of monster would wear such a horrible garment?
Hey, dude, I made it.
You've worn the same shirt every day for as long as I've known you. Why'd you have to change into that one tonight?
No problem. If you don't like it, I'll take it off.
Oh, how insensitive.
Sanford, this is not cool. And it's not even true. There are fat girls. Look at Becky.
You tell him, Delzer.
Fine. If it means that much to you, I'll take this one off, too.
There is no God! Please, put that offensive shirt back on.
Let's get out of here.
This is the last feminist comedy night I invite you to. Barry, wait up.
Oh, yeah? Well, maybe this is the last feminist comedy night you ever invite me to. Swish. I'll find some new friends, too.
Those are fake.
Oh, this is stupid. Where do people go to find new friends? The dorm? There's usually some dudes in the shower. Maybe I'll start hanging out there. Hey, dudes.
Dude, your leg is awesome.
Can you guys take me to the hospital? I think I need some medicine.
Oh, man, we were kind of on our way to a movie at the drive-in.
Is Wesley Stripes in it?
No.
Arnold Schwarzkopf?
Look, guy, we gotta get going if we're gonna snag that parking spot by the women's bathroom.
Can I come with you guys?
You got any money?
Well, I have the shirt.
Oh, that's clever. It really says something, you know? Something about fat girls.
All right, come on. We'll sneak you in the trunk.
Thanks. I'm Sam. Hey, a road flare. Cool. Oh no, that's not good. Ow. Ow! Whew, a fire extinguisher.
Uh-oh.
Dudes, tell me when I need to be quiet. Until then, I'm gonna work on my rap. Sanford in the Trizon, boy!
Dude. This dude is all like, dude.
Say no more.
Are we there yet?
Hey, Becky. Thanks for tutoring me this past week. It's really paid off. One professor actually handed back my quiz instead of throwing it at my head.
My pleasure, Dow. I think you'll find that success breeds success.
My uncle breeds rabbits. Hey, who's that guy in the dress?
That's the dean, you pud.
The Delzer called it a dress. Oopsie, I just baked an air muffin.
Del Swanson, you are outrageous with a capital O! And there's nothing I like more than a big O.
Then you must love that Hollywood sign.
I prefer the Washington Monument.
I've seen it. Looks nothing like him.
He's not funny. Why are you guys laughing? That's stupid.
Oh, Barry, go lay an egg.
Hey, Barry, what's the capital of Thailand?
Hey, guys, grab me a Zagnut or some bonbons.
You should have seen me just now in the cafeteria. I walked right up to the most crowded table and sat down.
Not interested.
I just wish Sanford were here to see how well I'm doing when he's not here.
When is this movie gonna start?
You haven't had any food in days. Here, eat this. It's not an oily rag. It's a piece of lasagna.
Don't do it, boyo. It's a trick. He got you to eat the tire, and we all know how that ended.
Shut it, leprechaun.
Sweet.
The bathroom is for customers only.
Well, don't worry, son. A lot of people lead normal lives with only one testicle. How'd this happen, anyway?
Well, someone asked me what the capital of Thailand was, and I said Bangkok.
Oh! Sorry, I couldn't help myself. Oh, that's a classic. So I guess we better have a look at that.
Hope you're hungry for popcorn. I busted out the movie theater style.
Remember when you had to go all the way to the movie theater to get movie theater style popcorn? It's almost like we're living in the future, or in a movie theater.
Becky is so awesome. She's really great, don't you think?
I guess.
She has such a good sense of humor. She's smart and reasonably attractive. Becky's awesome. Don't you think Becky's awesome?
Are you still talking?
Oh my God, I forgot my student ID at the library. I better go get it. You can start the movie without me.
I don't know how to say this, but I think Janice likes you.
Oh, Del Swanson, can't you ever be serious? I need your help with a headline, Mr. Wordsmith. The story's about a girl. She falls in love with this super guy, but she isn't sure if he feels the same way about her.
Does this story have any nudity in it?
She wants to tell this guy how she feels, but she's afraid. So tell me, does the story have a happy ending? Write me a headline, Del Swanson.
I'll write you a headline, Del Swanson. Uniballer kills campus wit.
Barry?
I don't get it. What's a uniballer?
That's me. I had to have one of my testicles removed because of your stupid Bangkok joke. First you steal my headlines, then my testicle, and then my girl.
I can't believe I have two men fighting over me.
Well, actually, one and a half. I guess I lost my gift. I had a hell of a run.
Barry, is this true what you say?
Yes. I love you. I've always loved you.
No, silly bones. I mean about your gonad.
Del! Del!
Sanford?
Dude! Help me open the trunk!
Man, am I glad to see you.
Yeah, I'm glad to see you too. And your Coke. Give me that.
What are you doing in there?
We're sneaking into a drive-in movie. Want to come with us?
Sure. You're not going to believe what I've been through lately. Some chick tried to kiss me.
Dude, you scored? Without me?
Not really. Well, I guess so. Sort of.
That's awesome! You're the first one of us to score in college! You're like Mr. Popular.
Yeah, I'm Mr. Popular.
Meet the Aqua Teen Hunger Force. Here's Frylock, the Potato Man. Frylock's the smart one. Now let's meet Meatwad. He's not smart, but he's cute. People relate to Meatwad, especially stupid people. Uh-oh, here's Mr. Shape.
Dancing is forbidden.
What an a-hole. Say hello to neighbor Carl. He's impotent. That must be hard on Carl. Why not spend an evening with the Aqua Teen Hunger Force, right here on Adult Swim?
There's something evil in my house.
On April 15th, the windows are the eyes to its soul. The Amityville Horror, rated R, starts Friday, April 15th.
I know what's been troubling you. Listen to me.
Only through me can you achieve a power greater than any Jedi.
I can feel your anger. It makes you stronger.
PG-13.
The game was as sultry as a Rio sunset, but tougher than the last level of Doom 2. She moved gracefully, like a jungle cat, smooth and sure as a Klingon warship, and twice as deadly.
Hey, buddy boy. What's your hurry, huh, Alex? Trailing that goth babe again?
No. I was just, enjoying the day.
Yeah, right. Nice day for a stalk.
I wasn't stalking.
Oh, right. I've been watching you follow her for 20 minutes.
Yeah, I was just, Hey, what the hell are you doing following me?
Girls don't like being spied on, Alex. It's creepy. Either tell her you like her or give up and put us all out of our misery.
Oh, you not miserable? Impossible. Oh, damn. And I'm just trying to get to know her better.
By lurking in dark alleys? Let me tell you all you need to know, okay? Superficial poser, all right? Hate girls like that.
Yeah, like you know so much about her.
Look, I know that anyone with $10 can buy fishnet stockings. It doesn't automatically make you exotic.
Actually, I really like the kind with the black and white stripes.
She's not even worth stalking.
I'm not stalking!
It's never gonna go anyplace.
Oh, it will.
Mm-hmm.
You'll see.
Oh, I'll see.
Someday I'll get with her.
Mm-hmm. If she doesn't file a restraining order first.
Look, I gotta go. I'm late for work.
I thought you were just getting off, so to speak.
I gotta pull the night shift because I screwed up a big job the other day. Can I borrow that umbrella?
What?
Thanks.
Hey! She's as deep as a puddle, Alex.
Hey, Jen. You looking for Alex? Because he hasn't been in today.
You know, it's not like everything in my life involves Alex.
Okay. Then what are you looking for?
Oh, I don't know. Got any more alternative comics about lonely loser guys who draw alternative comics about lonely loser guys? You make my life seem exciting.
Sure. Back wall on the left.
I am captivated.
Do you think she looks like a Frazetta?
Please don't make me look at her anymore.
Ooh, too slow. Caught looking.
Seems like you have quite a little fan club.
Those guys again. I wish they'd go back to whatever basement they crawled out of.
You want me to toss their pasty asses out?
Nah, they're harmless. They wouldn't know what to do with a real girl anyway.
What'd I do for just a few minutes with that?
Yeah, I'd give up my old school 12-inch Darth Vader in a box for just one night with her.
But Ron, it's Darth!
Listen, Wedge, I know you don't want to hear this, but there are some things that are worth trading a 12-inch Darth for. Besides, his articulation sucks.
No, I'm not listening.
It'd take a lot more than old Darth to get Serena even to look at the likes of us. She is a woman of mystery and power. You'd probably need a Yoda.
I bet she studies the magical arts and dances in Central Park and naked pagan rituals.
Oh my.
Nah, she ain't the new age type. She's probably the leader of a gang of tough, bisexual motorcycle chicks.
You're right, young. Probably more your class. Yeah, I definitely...
You guys really need to get laid.
Oh, hey, Jen.
Hey, never heard of him. Is she part of the Star Wars expanded universe? Because I'm sure I have all the ones from the movie.
Man, laid is not an action figure, Wedge.
She's not? Oh, well, I guess I don't have to get him after all.
Alex, we can't have any more screw-ups. You've been spacing out lately.
Hey, the other day, that lady asked for 4,000 copies, not 400.
I know how it is. You see a nice piece walking in, and you think that if you slide her a few extra copies, she'll, you know.
What are you talking about?
I used to be young once, too. But I'm still gonna have to take the difference out of your paycheck.
Oh, that seems fair.
Anyway, this is an important job. Some big shot lawyer needs these charts for a big case tomorrow. Jimmy will be in tonight to help you. The messenger will pick the stuff up at 6 a.m. And Alex?
Yeah?
Try and keep it in your pants tonight. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Jen. Sorry about my geeky friends there, but they are simply hopeless when it comes to women. So, you know, the archive is showing Spinal Tap tonight.
Don't even bother, Mikey.
Oh, well. Okay. Well, I'm off to find me a chick who can appreciate fine cinema.
Oh. Hey, wait a sec. What do you know about that goth girl you guys are all so stiff over?
Serena?
Yeah.
I know that she's super hot. Oh, but of course, nothing compared to you, my dear.
Right, yeah. I mean, what's her deal?
I didn't want to get into it back at the store. Let the kiddies have their little fantasies, you know. But she's bad news. She's into all kinds of illegal stuff.
Well, take care, all. I heard about a sweet old wall up on 181st just crying to be bombed.
I'm going on for some Monday Nitro. Any plans tonight, Serena?
Wouldn't you like to know?
And not an upscale strip club like Scores, but the kind where the girls have nasty implant scars. Not that I've been there or anything. So, about Tap?
Sorry, I gotta go. But here, just so there's no hard feelings, I'll buy you dinner.
Hey, Alex, I'm promoting this eco-bondage event tonight, so could you do a rush job on these flyers?
Sorry, Lizzie. You'll have to self-serve. Here's a copy key. Repro Man's. Oh, hey, Jimmy. Oh, man, you're kidding. Well, I hope you feel better, I guess. Bye.
What's up?
The guy that's supposed to come in and help me is too hungover.
Speaking of which, have you seen Chaka around?
No, she hasn't stopped by. Hey, Lizzie?
Huh?
You ever run into that Serena girl at one of your clubs?
The Morticia from Starbase?
Yeah. Do you know anything about her?
I think that she has a porn website.
Really? Do you know the address by any chance?
No, but I think it's called Serena Land or something. I'm not into the goth thing, it's too depressing.
No!
I didn't even ask you yet!
What?
I didn't even ask you for any money yet. Can you please spot me a 20?
We started out with enough, but Kochek is like $2 an item.
I told you not to wear one.
But it's cold.
Here, now leave. I'm in the middle of something.
Mm-hmm. Whatever.
I screwed up the printer, okay?
Please tell me she's not humping that gravestone.
Oh, by the way, you just missed your friend Lizzie.
Lizzie? She is so not one of our friends.
She's like bottom of the barrel.
Really? She's like not connected with reality at all. Hello? She's like always walking around weirdly preaching like raver pride, except she never dances at any parties. She's always looking like she's about to die.
Seriously, that's like the eeriest thing about her. She looks like death impersonated. It's so weird. It's not like black makeup and black hair. She's not goth, but it's like, it's in her face. You can see it in her eyes and her nose. And so creepy. It's like death. Like
she's like dead. Like frozen dead.
Totally. Don't you think so, Alex?
Yeah, she does. Now why don't you two just get out of here?
She takes your whole body and starts like sucking you in. She's all like,
I'm sucking.
Chaka, she's not that bad.
Oh my God, shut up. Yes, she is.
Guys, I really
tonight,
have to...
I was like, I just like had to go out, you know? And I was like calling everyone in my phone book and nobody was home. So I was like, oh my God, I cannot believe I'm calling Lizzie.
I couldn't believe it
and
either.
And out of nowhere, my savior, Mecca, walks by and I'm like, Lizzie, call me right back or something.
Yeah, right.
Right? So we like ditched or whatever. We didn't even like wait for her to call back.
Here, it's all I have. Now please just get out and let me finish this job.
Thanks, bro. Love you.
Love you?
Shut up.
Oh no.
Tito, you've cut into my turf one too many times. I'm gonna have to put you down.
Oya chica, you and what army, huh?
This one!
Hey, we want to have a word with you. Yeah, someone just held up the liquor store over on A. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you? Yeah, all right, up against the wall. He's clean.
Hey, I'm a girl.
You're a girl?
Oh. Yeah, she is. I think.
Watch it, buddy.
Hey, Alex, we just got the Midnight Show Spinal Tap, and we were wondering, you know, if we could just get on the net, you know what I'm saying, just for a few minutes. Hey, guys, come on, I have this huge job due tonight. Any other night would be fine, but just not tonight.
Oh, man. I didn't know that comics chick had her own website. Oh, you've been holding out on us, Alex.
Oh, man.
Oh, you bastard.
Try F1.
What, you can't download porn on your own computers? Well, yeah, but you got the super fast modem.
Oh, come on, Alex. I'll trade you the naked code for Tomb Raider 3 for 1 hour of internet access.
Plus, you'll get a zip disk of all the best stuff we download.
Oh, damn. Okay. But stay off my workstation. SavageLoins.com, anyone?
Roll initiative.
Get out of my way.
Easy or rough? What's your pleasure?
Easy? Rough?
Give the man a prize.
Poor Alex.
And face it, Alex, you're never going to escape. You have to get with a girl to get out of the pit.
Oh, screw you guys, I'm getting out.
When you say get with a girl, exactly what do you mean?
Well, you have relations with a female.
Relations? Like my mom?
Ew.
Alex, just give it up. The pit is our lot in life. An ongoing daily hell of self-loathing, isolation, and comic books that will only get worse until you're finally released by the sweet kiss of a 357.
What I want to know, Alex, is why haven't you done anything with that fine-looking friend of yours?
Serena?
No. Jen!
Jen? Sick. No way. I think of Jen kind of like you guys. Well, maybe not, but the point is, I don't see her that way.
Yeah, right. Like, you never thought about doing it with her.
No, I haven't.
What do you think about me doing it with her?
Oh, guys, my constitution.
Hey, you didn't network the computers together to play Quake again, did you?
No.
Oh, the charts. I didn't save the file.
Why are you so fussy? I mean, it seems like lettuce is the only... Oh, Mickey.
Janice, 2F.
Are you the one that plays that awful rap music so loud?
Oh, no. I hate it. I can't stand that couple on 8 with the crying baby.
How long have you been in the building?
years. And what about that girl Serena? You know the one. Black dress, black hair, black soul. She's so selfish, never puts the top back on the garbage can.
I don't think I know her.
Sure you do. Men in and out of her apartment at all hours.
Oh, sure. The divorcee.
Divorcee?
About 45. Tries to look half her age. Has that nasty parrot.
Never mind.
And what's that horrible smell coming from 12D? Why is the change machine always broken in the laundry room? Do you like Tony Bennett?
Hey, Ace. I was just heading out. You up for some action?
I can't, Goat. I'm here until 6. I gotta finish this huge-ass job, and everyone and their mother keeps interrupting me.
Oh, yeah. I love girls who are into that whole death trip.
You can pull the life is short crap, and before you know it, you got black lipstick all over you.
I'm dead. I have to finish this job, and there's all these screw-ups.
Don't sweat it, man. I screwed up on the job once.
Job?
Yeah, I was employed. This was before I developed my credit card juggling skills. Anyway, look, I was working at this country club.
Go. Don't tell me you were a preppy.
Well, no, I was just more clean-cut back then. We used to joyride around on the carts in the middle of the night. Couldn't see a damn thing. So one night, I drive one right into the lake, completely wrecked. The ducks are freaking out.
And you get fired.
Well, no. Me and my buddies dragged the cart out, got a couple of shovels, and buried it. Took hours, but no one ever noticed it was gone. The key to solving any problem? Get rid of the evidence.
You here to dance?
Are you kidding?
Well, we're not picky. You'd be surprised what some guys go for.
I'm not here to dance.
Then that'll be $25.
$25? To watch some third-rate reject from Scores jiggle her implants?
Plus, a three-drink minimum.
Oh, hey, man, I didn't see the one with the boots before. Don't throw it out, I'll take it.
Goat! Oh, damn, it's locked. And there's no way out of this alley. You know, sometimes I really hate you.
You're just confusing hate with envy.
Oh, there goes my minimum wage job.
Cool. Now the world is yours.
Wait, hold up. Do you think we can get to that?
Hey, I'm a regular escape artiste. Did I ever tell you about the time me and the sales gal were doing it in the dressing room at closing? We got locked in. Had to use the heating ducts to get out.
Goat, just give me a hand up.
Oh, man, three-way mirror? Oh, it was beautiful.
Keep going, little guy.
Ah, sorry. Just passing through.
Not a problem.
How's it going, Lenny?
Hey, goat. What's shaking?
It's so sad when it stops.
At least nothing got stolen.
Well, I try to control myself. After all, you do work here.
Oh, it can't be 4 a.m. I'll never finish on time. Oh, no. Not him. I told you last time I can't Xerox any organic matter.
It's nothing like that. I need this at 83%. Not 82%. Not 84%. Exactly 83%. Actually, can you do fractions?
I don't have time for this.
What's this, a novel?
In progress. I finally finished the introduction. It draws upon two rarely combined genres, espionage and haiku.
I'd read that.
You wrote this all by hand? Why don't you get a computer?
I hate those boogers. I'm a neo-Luddite. I liked it better when surfing was on the water and the web was for spiders.
I like this guy. Don't worry, I'll help him out. You know, I once wrote a poem about my scrotum.
Hey, I wrote a three-act play about mine.
Hey, goat, lock the door, okay? I don't need any more stupid interruptions. Don't let anyone in.
Sure thing, boss.
Come on, you guys, hurry up, let me in.
You said to keep everyone out, right?
Not her, open the door.
Alex, my love, I've come.
Serena, my tulip.
I'm so glad I have you to myself now. That prying little bitch Jen isn't around.
Yeah, I told her I had to work the night shift so I could get rid of her.
Good. I hate her. She's stupid.
And immature.
And don't forget that.
How could I?
Want to do it on the copy machine?
Sons of bitches.
Alex, I'm being stalked. I went to pick up some stuff from my herbalist. Then I went to my aunt's house to water her plants. I don't know, I had to go pick up some Dead Can Dance tickets for my friend Christy, too. And the entire time, this guy was following me. This short, dumpy guy with a knit cap. I keep trying to lose him, but he's all over me. I think he's outside.
I'll call the cops.
Hold on a second. She's here with us now, and she's safe.
But he could be dangerous.
Exactly. Come here. Listen, I'm trying to help you out, man. If you go out there and prove your manhood by trouncing this guy, she'll be yours.
But what if he's a psycho? And I still haven't started the
What's
job.
What's more important, a hot chick or some mind-numbing, spirit-crushing job that a lobotomized monkey could do?
I need a portrait for my dust jacket.
The girl.
Me and Big A here are gonna go throw out some trash, if you know what I mean, so you just sit tight.
You know, Alex, I could just call a cab.
We'll be right back. Lock the door behind us and you'll be fine.
But I'm claustrophobic.
Hey, Goat. You got any more of that homebrew beer?
Can't talk now. Gotta go kick some ass.
Go, Goat.
Always go for the balls. That's what my mom taught me.
Goat? Alex? What the hell are you guys doing?
Jen? Look, I should ask you the same thing. Are you the stalker?
A stalker?
Yeah. Serena came in all freaked out and told us about some guy trailing her all night.
Some guy? What?
And you said she wasn't worth stalking.
You know, Alex, look, I was just trying to help you out, okay? I just didn't want you to get burned by some skis, that's all.
Yeah, right.
Guys, can I get a hand up?
I'm telling you, she picked up what looked like at least 2 kilos, right? Uh-huh. Yeah, I followed her into this ritzy building where I don't even want to know what she was up to, right?
Ooh.
Yes, and then she pulled a shift at the Cheeky Doll.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so I think it's only fair that you know that the love of your life is a drug-dealing S&M hooker stripper.
Rock on! Was that before or after she watered the plants?
Jen, I don't know where you get your info.
My own eyes, baby.
So, Jen, I'm sorry I kicked you in the balls.
Goat, contrary to popular belief, I'm female.
Oh, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry I kicked you in the balls, too. How they doing?
They're a little swollen, but nothing that can't be fixed with some healthy exercise.
Lucky for me, that lawyer's witness got whacked last night. Otherwise, I'd be filling out unemployment forms.
Hey, guys. Just wanted to stop in and thank you again for kicking that dumpy guy's ass, you know, escorting me home.
Dumpy?
Well, you know, it wasn't really all bad.
Damn right it was! My man Alex was a beast!
Oh, really? Come on.
I got you a little something.
Oh, you really didn't have to.
Go ahead, open it.
Yeah, go ahead, open it, hero.
You know, Matt said you were a fan.
Oh, Helen Wolf. Thanks.
Sure. And, here's something for you, too.
Deodorant!
All right, well, take care, you guys. See you later.
Hey, bye.
Take it easy.
Thanks a lot. Whoa, did you guys see that?
You told her you beat up some psycho? I can't believe you lied to her.
Well, what was I supposed to say? Oh, it's just my lunatic stalker friend, Jen.
Hey, Jen's stalking days are over. Stalking now is for desperate, pathetic losers only.
Jen.
Goat, walk me home, huh?
Yeah, sure thing, babe.
Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Look at my freaking car.
The Brack Show.
You fell.
Your father and race were...
Butts. Harvey Birdman, Attorney at Law. D-Lab 2021.
You broke the monitor, and you're dead. Happy.
Cowboy Bebop. And Space Ghost Coast to Coast.
This is Willie Nelson.
No kids under 17, though. So that's new, too. Sunday at 10, Adult Swim, on Cartoon Network.
One way or another, I'm on
Doritos, nacho cheesy or chips. That nacho cheese taste, that big crunch, nothing even comes close. Gotta get Doritos.
Freshman.
Chainsaw Man is back with Dr. Tina Vogel. So, Doc, you really think you can hypnotize me in 5 seconds?
Absolutely.
And nobody's getting into my melon, lady.
We'll see, Chainsaw.
Do you believe this stuff?
Total hype. Tell me about it.
When I count to three, you will be fast asleep. One,
two, three.
This stuff?
Total hype.
Tell me about it.
We're off now. We're flying. And there's no denying. We're driving. Anywhere but home is the way that we will go.
Before we get there.
Where?
Wherever it is we're going.
Where are we going?
I don't know. I thought you knew.
Well, I thought you knew.
You mean to tell me that we've been driving for 14 hours straight without a destination?
Bingo.
I can't do this, Mike. I'm not a go-with-the-flow kind of person. I need a destination.
Want to go to that observatory?
Okay.
The comet you see projected above you was discovered during the shooting of Baywatch Nights when amateur astronomer David Hasselhoff, known for spotting heavenly bodies, gazed skyward and saw the astronomical phenomenon now known as the comet Hasselhoff. Now, this comet only appears in our solar system every 6,000 years, and it'll only be visible for the next four nights. I've been waiting all my life to witness a comet like this with my naked eye.
Oh, my eyes! Oh, I can't see! It's burning!
I'm gonna take a wild guess and say the show's over.
I need to see that comet.
Don't worry, sir. You'll get your sight back in 5 days.
No!
What a tragedy.
Yeah, I don't know why, but I almost feel responsible.
Hello? Excuse me.
Hi.
Hi. How was the show?
It just got better.
What's your name?
Let me translate, ladies. He's Gary, and I'm Mike.
Hi, I'm Vi.
And I'm Lee.
Wow. I don't mean to be rude, but is your dad a terrorist?
Why?
Because you're the bomb.
Perfect. Want to spend the night at our place?
Does a chicken have nuggets?
Follow us.
I'm Gary.
Those hotties are good to go. We're getting the grail tonight, guaranteed.
I'm down with that.
What's something wrong?
Why do you think something's wrong?
Oh, wait a minute. This wouldn't have anything to do with the ladies, would it?
I'm just a little uncomfortable about this.
Listen, I know it's been a while, but it's like riding a bike. Think back to prom night with Lisa the Enabler Gabler.
Mike?
Yeah?
Lisa Gabler and I, we never actually did it.
What? But you told me that...
I lied.
Yeah, but she told me...
I paid her to lie.
No, wait a minute. You're telling me you're actually a cherry? I'm driving with a cherry?
Yes, I am.
Oh, my God.
It's not that big a deal, Mike.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Mike!
Oh, Gary, shameful little secret.
Come on, Mike, stop it.
Oh, the inhumanity. Get a watermelon,
it's
man.
It's not funny. Sex really freaks me out.
Why?
In answer to your questions about sexual intercourse, son, this should clear it all up.
It's no secret that many of you visit prostitutes. You may think you've got a clean one, but when it's all said and done, you've got yourself a dose, a stain, the clap, the gleet, the whites, morning drop, gonorrhea. And now you're in real trouble, soldier. But don't take my word for it, Private Goner.
Hey there, Sarge.
What have you been up to, Private?
Oh, just visiting the boys in Charlie Company.
Uh-oh. Let's see how they're doing. Just as I thought. Remember, sex outside of marriage is a sin against God, country, and your commander-in-chief, President Kennedy.
Oh, man, nightmare on Gary Street. Now, me, I learned about the Humpty the old-fashioned way.
Hey, Dad, you want to play catch?
Whew. Not now, son. I'm kind of busy.
Is that your son, Tom?
Hey, he looks just like it.
Run along now, Mikey. Mommy, Daddy, and the Kelvins are having adult time.
And now, my friend, it's your turn for adult time.
Oh, God.
Come on in.
Oh, God.
Look, you can do this. Just suck it up.
Greetings, fellow containers.
Their Earth names are Gary and Mike.
Greetings, Gary and Mike.
This is bad.
Just chill. No matter what happens, I always got your back.
Hey, you want to go for a walk?
Later.
Mike! Mike, where are you going, Mike?
Hello. My name is Ba.
Hello. Oh, great, Ba, huh? What's your last name, Humbug? Get it? Because your name is Ba. I'm going to stand over here.
What would you say if I told you that our bodies are merely husks, temporary containers for our unenlightened souls?
Kind of like corn?
Exactly.
I'd say it's time to start shucking.
Now, once enlightened, we leave our husks behind and move on to a better place. Are you following me, son?
I don't feel good.
Exactly. That's why you're here.
And that's why you're here.
Oh, I know exactly why I'm here.
No, wait, Mike. I can only be with someone who's a hard and fast believer.
Well, I'm halfway there.
This week, as Hasselhoff passes overhead, a window will open in the heavens. We call that window Glory's Hole, and we must pass through it to be delivered. That's why we call ourselves the Glory Holians.
Please don't take this the wrong way, sir. But one, you're insane. Two, everybody here is insane. And three, anybody who'd fall for this crap is a mindless idiot.
Listen up, container people! I was a sinner, just a beginner, but now I've been saved. 'Cause we're going to a wondrous place, where everybody's got a smiling face. Oh, blasting off towards Comet Hasselhoff. Oh, Comet Hasselhoff's gonna get us off through Glory's Hole. Yes, we're shooting through Glory's Hole.
Mike, what are you doing? Mike, we gotta get out of here before they break out the punch. This place is a cult.
I'm so sorry to hear you say that, fellow container. Try opening your husk holes and join us, or you'll be lost forever.
Can I just get a burger?
Afraid not. Boss says because transcendence is light, all our food must be white.
Transcend delicious!
Mayonnaise and whipped cream for your cauliflower?
Oh, yeah, bring it on, Daddy.
Could I talk to you for a second?
I shall be receptive to your comments, fellow container.
Mike, you're freaking me out! Are you still in there? Would you relax? I'm just playing along. I'm this close to getting my corn creamed. This Ba guy's obviously brainwashed a bunch of weak-willed losers with no self-esteem.
Exactly, they're the easiest to nail. Those Manson family chicks put out constantly.
Look, you do what you want. I'm sleeping in the car.
Oh, come on. You could have a nice white meal and groove with the ladies, or go freeze your ass off out in the prairie.
I'll take the prairie. It's safer. Actually, I think I'll stay.
Good choice, my friend. I guarantee we won't be sleeping alone tonight.
Oh, God, I hope that's my inhaler.
White light!
Steer right, three, you're out!
But still loved.
Gary!
Hurry! Grab a bat! You're up!
No, you don't want me in the game right now, sir. I'm not very good.
Oh, nonsense. Who told you that?
All right, hustle up. Bill, let's pick teams.
I'll take Hogan.
Wallace.
Marvin.
Brenner.
Fat Kid.
Okay, down to the last pick. Guess I'll take... Susie.
Yes!
But, Dad...
This isn't about family, son. It's about victory.
Yeah, you should really pick Mike.
Come on, Gary. Get up there. Remember, son, it's not about getting a hit. It's about believing in yourself. I believe in you.
Okay.
And try choking up on the bat a little. Tonight, we welcome our two newest containers as they become full-fledged Glory Holians by choosing the names they will carry with them into the new life. Gary?
I choose Gah.
Praise be Gah.
Praise be Gah.
And now, Mike? Mike!
Huh?
Praise be her.
Praise be her.
Gary, I know you want to go, but I'm about this close to transcending Lee's brains out.
Take all the time you need, huh? Because this is one contented container.
Are you okay, Gary?
It's Gah, huh? And I've never been better. This really feels like home. Everyone likes me, even the She-Husks.
Oh, no. What have I done?
You just turned me on to the greatest place on Earth. Even being a virgin is cool here.
Taking a communal dump is cool here, but that doesn't make it right.
Boss says it's cool.
Oh, well, if anyone knows cool, it's a 52-year-old bald guy with a name tag. Look, you said yourself he's scamming the hell out of these freaks.
No, Boss selfless. His light is pure.
Rip Torn is not doing my life story. You get me Harrison Ford or UPN can shove it! Now, where were we?
Your group snuff is gonna make the cult footwear market mega hot. We want our shoes on your corpses.
So, excite me.
Done. Introducing Air Bah.
Surpass. Outdo. Transcend.
You make Bob bigger and Air smaller, and we've got a deal.
Lee?
Hey.
I just came to say goodbye.
Why?
It's Gary. He's in too deep. I gotta get him out of here.
But he's so happy.
All right, let me tell you about Gary and happiness. When he was 10, he got a remote control airplane, and he was insanely happy. The first time he flew it, he crashed it.
So?
Into his new puppy.
Oh, no.
Well, the puppy lived for 10 more years.
That's good.
Without the use of its hind legs. I mean, every time he looked at that stumpy little mongrel pulling itself along on its tiny little rickshaw, he was reminded of the horror that his happiness brings. So, we gotta split before it all comes crashing down.
But I don't want you to go, Mike. It's been so much fun since you got here.
Hey, why don't you come with us?
I can't. This is my family.
Well, Gary's about the only family I've got, so... well, I guess this is goodbye. Wow! If I'd known that's all I had to say to get the good goodies, I would have said bye a long time ago.
You remember to bring proof of insurance when you drive through our county!
Sheriff, what the hell's that thing sticking out of the old Hanson bar?
Oh, looks like those freaks got themselves a Scud missile.
We better call that in.
Reckon we oughta.
Oh, what do we do with the out-of-towner?
Don't worry, I'll take care of him.
Dear Mom and Dad, I'm doing great. I found a group of caring, wonderful people who have accepted me as I am. I've never felt so safe.
Fellow containers, transcendence is at hand.
Yeah!
Hello, Pa here, messenger of peace.
This is the police. We have your compound surrounded.
Go to hell, pig! Do, re, mi! It's showtime! Come on now, let's go, let's go! They start shooting, turn them into red mist! Everybody, everybody, move over to the wall! They're about to fire!
How's that feel?
A little tight in the tone.
Yeah, let's go with the 7.
Excuse me, Ba. I know you're busy, but what's with the Scud missile? Are we gonna attack the government?
Oh, no. Nothing that crazy. You see those seat belts along the side there? We're going to strap ourselves to the Ark and blast off into space, rendezvous with Comet Hasselhoff, ride through Glory's Hole, and transcend into the eternal new life.
Man, this just gets better and better.
I just want you to know that even after the operation, I'll still have these feelings for you, huh?
Cool. Wait, did you just say operation?
Yeah, didn't they tell you? All Glory Holian males have to be castrated to transcend. Only you and Gaul are left. I wrote you a poem about it. Sexless, sackless man-woman boys. Was it something I said?
There you are, huh? Grab a weapon.
We gotta get out of here.
Be patient. We don't transcend for another 7 minutes.
Listen, Gary, Bob's gonna...
I know. He's gonna bring us to a place where we don't have to worry about material wealth or our fathers or virginity.
Exactly. He's gonna cut off
our... No, I'm not going, huh?
Oh, yes, you are. You're coming with me.
No, he's coming with us. Gah, are you ready to take the final step?
I am, Ba.
Remove his man sack.
My what?
Your clackers! That's what I've been trying to tell you!
Oh, time out.
Okay, step off with the blade, ho.
Listen not to the betrayer, he does not believe!
The only thing I believe is that me and Gary are modern-day explorers, and we've got way too many good times ahead to do it man-sackless.
Nonsense!
Come on, Gary. Look at these people! He's taken their souls, their manhood, and since he's a cult leader, probably all their cash, right?
Yep, every penny.
See what I'm saying? Gary, you don't want to be a part of that. And neither do any of you. Come on, everybody, let's go!
You know something? The kid's got a point.
Yeah, we really don't have anything to live for.
Everyone, to the Ark!
Let's go, people!
Buckle up for safety.
I don't know how to thank you, Mike. I guess I was hoping Ba would show me the path to salvation, but I've learned that no quick fix can bring true happiness.
Want to make $50,000 a week by placing classified ads in newspapers?
Sure.
Come on, I'll show you how.
Later.
How much later? Because I'm only going to be here till midnight, probably. Hey, man.
Hey. Thanks for getting me out of there.
I don't thank me, man. You know, I got us into this thing in the first place.
Yeah, but I bought into Ba's whole program. I guess I'm just weaker than you are.
You're weak? I almost got de-nutted for a one-night stand.
That's pretty weak. Can you believe it? All those poor, misguided people.
Following a complete moron.
Well, I'll be a son of a bitch. I was right. Oh, I can't believe it. So long, suckers.
You're watching Comedy Central. If you thought freshman year was rough, wait till you see it animated. Stick around for Undergrads, coming up next.
If you gotta get in the game, you gotta get with the family. Homer, Marge, Lisa, and Bart.
Don't you understand, son? Your whole life has been a video game.
This fall, roll with your homies.
Cool.
I start this riot in the name of decency.
Game over, man. Game over!
The Simpsons Game. Coming this fall to every platform ever made.
Whatever!
Shh.
Taco Bell's new Ranchero Chicken Soft Tacos bursting with so much great taste. You'll be floored by flavor. Make way for the big taste of the Ranchero Chicken Soft Taco. We pack it with our new marinated grilled all-white meat chicken. Then take things up a notch with freshly prepared fiesta salsa and a splash of zesty avocado ranch sauce. Whoa, for a burst of fresh flavor, think outside the bun.
No matter what I do,
do you love me or not?
No matter how hard I try,
Spider-Man killed my father. If you knew who he was, would you tell me?
The ones I love,
I'm getting married,
will always be the ones who pay.
I'm Spider-Man no more.
Let me slip away! Let me slip away!
Well, there was something I thought I had to do. I don't have to.
I like seeing you tonight, Peter. You take Spider-Man's pictures. Where is he?
There's a hero in all of us, even though sometimes we have to give up the thing we want the most.
There are bigger things happening here than me and you.
But I am cleaning up so well. I am seeing in me now the things you saw,
I wish I could tell the truth.
The story continues June 30th.
You tell them an icebreaker or two about women's libbers, gays, environmentalists, several minorities, the homeless, couple of religions, anorexics, obese people, the handicapped, old farts, baldness, and people who walk real goofy because they just had a vasectomy, and suddenly they get all sensitive, like I'd offended one of them or something. Makes you wonder why they even asked me to talk in the first place.
Wasn't it community service for that incident with the ladder at the second story window of the girls' dormitory?
I told the judge that was sort of case-related, in a way.
All I know is it's a good thing Cornfed was here to rescue you today.
Yeah, that was truly amazing how you ran up on stage, told a few amusing anecdotes, then reasoned the mob into taking the noose off his neck.
Not to mention how you got everyone to hold hands, sway back and forth, and sing "Everything is Beautiful" in polyphonic harmony.
Hey. Any ex-wandering troubadour slash hostage negotiator could have done it.
Look, I didn't need bacon breath here to save me, okay? I could have handled those panty waists. I was just waiting for the right moment to wind up the old haymaker and start dropping the bombs.
Yeah, right.
All we saw you dropping up there was your load.
Kids, if I may, you should always respect a parent over a close and seemingly more courageous friend of the family, no matter how moronic, obnoxious, craven, and cowardly the parent seems to be.
And don't you forget it!
Yo, throw the ball here, babe!
Now, here's something I have, shall we say, a small amount of expertise at. I bet you didn't know your old man played a little hoops in high school. That's right. I once almost covered a guy whose dad sold a car to the sister of the All-City High School basketball champ. Guess I ought to show these asphalt amateurs the meaning of showtime.
Go for it, Corn.
Let's see what you can do.
Move the cassava.
Well, I'll give it a whirl.
Dr. C!
Did you play in high school, too?
No, I was once kidnapped by a cabal of kickboxing ninja who forced me nightly to play a deadly game of steel cage basketball where the losers were beheaded.
Yeah, well, I'll bet there wasn't a shot clock.
And finally, remember, kids, floss daily to avoid tartar buildup, carpool whenever possible, and overtip food and beverage servers. It's 80% of their income.
Surprise!
Why? Well, thank you, everyone. I gotta admit, since my birthday was last week and no one said anything, I thought you forgot.
We did, you fly speck! This is for Cornfed!
Cornfed? His birthday's not for another 6 months!
We know, but we just couldn't wait.
Happy birthday!
By the way, in all the excitement, we forgot to tell you! You got a case!
All right, let's book, birthday boy. Everyone thinks you're so much better than me. Let them watch while I crack this case open like a three-egg omelet. Let them see for themselves you don't have half the observational skills that I do.
Where the hell are my keys?
In your right hand.
In your right hand. Little bovine pain in the...
It's a new game out here, Clovefoot. No soapboxes to stand on. No naive kids eating up your every stealing from their father move. This is my turf. You know, I'm in charge here, and I'm only gonna tell you once. No popping off! Well, now look what you made me do. I gotta go in there with a picture of me and Vanna White frolicking naked with a tribe of pygmies on my chest.
Looks like synchronized swimmers crocheting mittens in a pool filled with truffles to me.
You're sick. All right, let's go. And remember, I have a perfectly honed instinct for this work. You wanna learn something, do exactly as I do. Imitate my every move.
Do I have to do the yell, too?
Whoa! Howdy, partner. Did a shot to the keister, huh? It's the fried food. The grease makes things a little slick around here.
Yeah, thanks for the newsflash, Hopalong. Here's an idea that's sweeping the nation. Warning signs!
Oh. Keep them up there on the walls, huh?
Name's Bob, as in for apples. Bob Heine, all told. I'm general manager here. Any particular reason you got a picture of a drag queen on a Shetland pony licking a flaming banjo on your chest?
Right, never mind that! I'm Duckman, Private Eye. I'm here to investigate the, thing that needs investigating.
Sorry, partner, I'm not sure I know what y'all are talking about.
Look, Wyatt, I don't know how they do things on the planet Redneck, but around here, we cooperate with law enforcement officials.
You're only private investigator.
Don't sass me, Fry Boy! You won't talk, I can always apply a little persuasion.
You don't have to get ugly, son. Maybe Mrs. DeRee sent for you. Her husband just died. Come with me.
This is it, gentlemen. The DeRee Waffles and Roast Beef on a Stick Factory.
Interesting name for a business. What exactly do you make here?
Waffles and Roast Beef on a Stick, Duckman.
I know that, Mr. Second in Command, who wasn't asked the question. I was just seeing if he was cooperating yet.
Not bad.
Tastes like a little something extra is mixed in with the beef.
Of course there is. You think a rat problem like this side of town had just suddenly goes away? We like to say at DeRee's, roast beef is more than just a dead cow with its head chopped off. Here we are. Might want to go easy on her. She's been pretty torn up since he passed on.
So the midget says enjoy it.
Hell, I was eating lunch in there.
Yes? May I help you?
I'm Duckman, private detective and Renaissance duck. At your beck and call.
And I'm
insignificant at the moment. We understand there's a case you need us to investigate.
Yes, there is. Thank goodness you're here.
Excuse me, why do you have a picture of me, a rabbi, and six drunken longshoremen rolling around on a rubber bed on your chest?
About the case?
Of course. Yes, it concerns my poor Stanley.
Actually, he was very wealthy. By poor, I meant dead. There seems to be a suspicion that Stanley's death involved foul play. Clearly, there's nothing to support that theory, but the insurance company is insisting on an investigation. They won't even let me move the body until it's proven that he died of natural causes. Do you think you can help me?
Sorry, I didn't hear you. I was staring at your breasts.
I understand. They're very supple, I'm told.
Excuse me, Mrs. DeRee. I'm
beginning to annoy me. Go on, Mrs. DeRee.
Val, it's clear to even the most casual observer what killed Stanley. Cholesterol. Obviously, there are those who might think I killed my husband for the insurance money, then hired an idiot PI to say I didn't so I could get a big fat check and make immediate plane reservations to a sunny tropical resort and live happily ever after.
Oh, well, the fools. Oh, here, let me get those plane tickets to Rio for you. Well, it's clear you need to get your mind off your troubles. In fact, I know just the place. Beer nuts, scantily clad women dancing in cages. They know me there. I could get us a table in front.
Duckman, judging by some of the things in this room, I think we should ask Mrs. DeRee a few questions.
I told you to stay out of this! What's to be gained from asking this poor, sad, full-figured woman a bunch of meaningless questions? As far as I'm concerned, that's all this is. Just an open and shut case of improper diet. Pretty parrot. Say hello, Duckman.
Stop it, Val! You're killing me!
Well, fine, if you can't do it. As I was saying, my years of experience tell me this very rich and refreshingly flirtatious young lady is being needlessly harassed. This was not a murder.
Val, put down that gun! You're my wife! Don't shoot!
I can't hear myself think! The point being, as this busty and suddenly available one-nighter possibility is clearly innocent of any wrongdoing, it's our duty to do what we can to prove it. Never fear, Val. I'll be tireless in my efforts, for Duckman doesn't know the meaning of the word quit.
Apparently, the word clue slipped through the cracks as well.
Where do you get off pork rinds making a crack about my investigative abilities? Who the hell do you think you are?
I'm your partner, Duckman. Maybe I'm out of line and nail me to the barn and call me Hector if I am. But the truth is, you're blinded by lust. You're missing things no detective, even you, should ever miss. Duckman, I think the way you're acting is, well, I'll say it. Unprofessional.
Unprofessional? After everything else today, you have the gall to criticize me? Well, that's it, bacon fat. You can sit on a spit and rotate. From now on, you're one stuck pig, you hear me? Shove an apple in it, Buster. You're done. And I mean well done. Finished. Bring out the ketchup, folks. We got ourselves some pork chops, and they're going down hard.
Are you trying to tell me something?
Get out. You're not my partner anymore. You're fired.
I'm not an actor, but I play one on TV. And that's why I bikini wax with the new and improved Gee, Your Groin Looks Well Groomed.
Yeah, well, that's enough grooving on the tube. Very nice, very nice. No more cornfin around yammering all the time about this, that, this. Well, nothing like a stimulating game of darts to get the juices going. Yes, sirree, this is the life. Doing things my way. I'd say my life is pretty much right on target. Who needs a partner? It's about time I got things heading in the right direction. The reason people come to the Duckman Detective Agency is Duckman, not Cornfed.
Phone call for Mr. Cornfed. Fax for Mr. Cornfed. Carrier pigeon for Mr. Cornfed. Semaphore for Mr. Cornfed. Smoke signals for Mr. Cornfed.
Cornfed doesn't work here!
Let's try him at home.
What are you bothering me with all that stuff for? I told you, he's gone, fired. He was nothing but a big pink weight on my shoulders, and we're better off without him.
If you say so. How's the case going without him?
Case? What case? Oh, right, the case. I was just about to put it to bed.
Along with the client.
The kind of joke he probably enjoyed telling when Cornfed was around.
Hey, maybe it's time for you two hairballs to do something around here besides irritating the hell out of me.
You want our help
on a case?
Let's start with a couple of questions. Not that I don't already know the answers. I do. I just want to, you know, see how you're thinking. Suppose you're the chairman of a large...
Chairperson.
Suppose you're the chairperson of a large corporation that makes meat on a stick.
Oh, Mr. Duckman, we couldn't support the killing of animals for food, nor the senseless slaughter of trees for sticks.
Okay. You're the chairpeople of a large, environmentally friendly corporation that produces wholesome apples.
Now! You're supposed to prove that someone died of natural causes. What would you do?
Are the apples free?
So, Mr. Cornfed, I understand you recently joined the unemployed. What makes you think we'd have an opening here?
Wild guess.
Do you have a resume?
I just threw it together this morning.
I see you were a member of the Irish Parliament.
Sure, in Begora.
And under your interests, you list origami. What exactly is that?
Got a matchbook.
Impressive. But do you know anything about mail? Postal worker in rural China? Avid stamp collector? Author, so you want to be a mailman? Well, Mr. Cornfed, when can you start?
No time like the present. Could I use the restroom first?
Sure, you can't miss it. Make a right at the cow bones grinding and marrow extraction room, a quick left at the chicken squeezing ovum cracking pit, and then a sharp circle round the gobstopper and gizzard suction chamber.
I'll hold it in.
Sure, you're starting at the bottom. But like in every big corporation, some of our most promising executives-to-be are working right here in the mailroom. Your job is just to sort the mail, if you can hold on to it.
Got any napkins?
Napkins? That's brilliant!
Great idea!
Mr. Cornfed, you're going places here. In fact, next opening we get, you're moving out of this mailroom. First day, Corny.
Glad to be aboard, Bob.
What? I start all my investigations here. Hey, someone here might know something. Hey, the case is almost solved, so I'm 9 months behind. Didn't you ever hear of a grace period?
Stop that!
About Cornfed. I'll bet you laughed when they shot old Yeller, clapped when Bambi's mother died, cheered when Danny Bonaducci got busted. Ugh. All I can say is what you did really stinks.
Predicament.
Get me out of these!
Wow! I am sensing you're in pain.
Look, I'm desperate. I got nowhere else to turn. I can't crack this case. I've crawled through the bowels of this vermin-infested city searching for the answer. I've hit rock bottom. I can't think about anything else except this. These things free?
They're a dime, but it goes to the rainforest.
I owe him a nickel.
So you need a clue. Have a seat. This will cost you $20.
Here, anything for some help.
In that case, I meant 25. I know what the real problem is, but we'll have to go back into your past to find the solution. No, that's not it.
Psst, boys, boys. If you want the Prophet Cornfed, he'll be over at the garden, you know, Gethsemane.
Hey, everybody, look at this water I turned into vine.
No, that's not it.
Hey, everyone, look what I pulled out of the still.
That's not it either. I think we're searching for something in your present life.
Hey, I don't care if you are just working here till you graduate from astronaut school and orbit that planet. Everyone knows a baker's dozen is 13.
Duck.
Moron!
No, I mean duck.
You took a bullet from me?
It's all right. I've got another kidney.
Who are you?
The name's Cornfed.
Well, I'm Duckman. Want to be my partner?
Sure, if I don't die. Ooh, that smarts.
You're not gonna die. You're not gonna die. I'll get you to the hospital if it's the last thing I do. I won't think about anything else till I know you're all right. These things free.
Oh, well, there's always dialysis.
3 times? He didn't even know you, and he saved your life 3 times.
Yeah, I vaguely remember that. He's a good person, isn't he? Why, he never thinks of himself, always puts others first. He is a better person than me. That's why I did what I did. I'm jealous. I shouldn't feel that way about my best friend. I should be thankful he is my friend. I should get down on my knees and thank my lucky stars that a person like Cornfed is even in my life. Which, at the moment, he isn't. I gotta go find him and do anything I can to get him back.
Oh, what a magical, mysterious find you are. There's truly nothing else like you in the entire universe.
Oops. Just wondered if the ball knew where he was.
Excuse me, Mr. Reed. Bob's left on his vacation. I need you to sign these productivity reports.
Come in.
You're here awfully late.
Insomnia. Ought to stop by my place, try it with me sometime.
Odd. Take a look at the signature you just gave me. Now take a look at the signature on your trout fishing license. Clearly not the same. However, note the resemblance between this signature and Bob Heine's.
Those signatures look nothing alike.
Maybe not to the untrained eye, but I graduated first in my class from the John Hancock Institute of Graphology. My, my. Seems your Heine's in a sling, Bob. You deep-six the old man and set up his dame as a patsy, knowing the minute he was tucked in with a shovel, she'd take a powder to Rio and you could disguise yourself as her and take over the business. I just have to know, Bob. Was it the bloodlust? Was it the power? Was it the money?
Actually, I just wanted to be her. Wear her clothes. Put on her makeup. Set free the girlish passion that was dying for a voice.
That was my next guess.
Didn't count on an undercover pig being on me like pee on a bum's shoes. What gave it away?
The lavender handbag. Val has better fashion sense than that. You win, Heine. One last smoke.
You know, smoking can be deadly.
Soak an origami. Menial. Great tool.
What's that mean?
Let's get physical.
Sayonara, Cornfed.
Corny! Thank God I...
You saved my life.
Yeah, well, about time I paid you back. Listen, corny old boy, you and I have sort of a history together, and, well, what I'm trying to say is...
You want me back?
But not at the salary I was paying you. After all, you did run out on me. I had to crack this case by myself.
Whatever you say, Duckman. By the way, someone who knew you were feeling bad about things told me to remind you that there are a lot of ways one person can be better than another.
like in providing a home away from home for a partner, and in being the best father you know how.
Who told you that?
Your kids.
It is at that time you'll find a nice lineup of shows. C-Lab 2021.
I like my body. I love my body.
Space Ghost Coast to Coast.
Good one, Jace.
Good one, Jace.
Ah, now that's funny.
Home Movies.
Name's McGurk, and soccer's the game.
The Brack Show.
Brack, I can't see. Am I on the road?
Not really.
Cowboy Bebop.
How you doing, kid?
Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Fella, what are you doing here?
Are you ready to rock?
Coming this January is Baby Blues. That's a new one for us.
How can you guys stand that noise?
But keep in mind, no kids under 17 allowed. Adult Swim, Sunday and Thursday at 10, only on Cartoon Network.
Driven to the limit. Rally Sport Challenge 2. Rated E for everyone. Xbox. It's good to play together.
Here we are, boy. Bullworth Academy. Have fun, Jimmy.
Hopkins, you're quite the nastiest little boy I have ever encountered.
Okay, I'm frightened. And I've got a weak bladder.
Hey, Eggie.
You can clean my shoes.
This school is filled with wild beasts.
You want me to steal your stuff back from a bloodthirsty mob of angry greaseballs?
Get used to it, kid. You're a man.
No, no, no!
I always knew I was a born leader, Ernest.
I can do anything I like in this place. Anything at all.
This place is full of bullies and maniacs.
Nonsense. That's just school spirit.
Come here.
You're a degenerate. The thing I trusted you.
You're a pig. You've ruined my life.
Bullworth is a microcosm for the whole world.
I like you, Jimmy Hopkins, but I need you to do something
for
me.
Go away, Jimmy.
And boy, that nose of yours, keep it clean.
Welcome to Bullworth.
This product is not yet rated.
Attention, Adult Swim, all kids out of the pool. It's animation for mature viewers. Sort of. We've got specials. Regular series.
I warned her.
And some stuff that's, Hello, Betty. Adult Swim, Sunday at 10 on Cartoon Network.
I never stopped thinking about you. And when I heard you were back, I started to hope.
I could sense that things would never be the same.
Begins. Rated PG-13. In theaters and IMAX Wednesday, June 15.
We run with a fast crowd. A tough crowd.
We're like a mob.
43 asphalt warriors.
Guys have one motto.
What goes around,
comes around.
Eye for an eye. Fender for a fender. Paybacks are a promise.
Races end.
Rivalries don't.
You
You had a nice ride there. It'd be a shame if something were to happen to it.
Careful who you mess with, because now the pack doesn't forget. NASCAR Thunder 2004, rated E for everyone. EA Sports.
It's in the game.
During the Dark Ages, which was a very pious and righteous time in our history, don't we?
But the Dark Ages sound scary.
Well, they're not. Dark, in this case, means something more like shade and shelter. To be in a cool, dark place, away from the oppressive heat of blinding enlightenment.
Believe it, or else.
Oh. But then the Renaissance came and ruined everything when artists started taking the clothes off all their paintings. Orel.
What were the Crusades all about, Miss Goltham?
It was a holy war to retrieve lost artifacts and symbols of Christianity. You see, symbols of our religion are very precious and should not be discarded. That's why it's a sin to throw the Bible off a cliff or flush a cross down the toilet.
Believe it, or else.
Oh. Ooh, ooh.
Yes.
So what did they end up getting back from the Crusades?
Well, as you can see, many of the artifacts are here behind this glass. We have the Holy Grail.
Oh.
A porthole from Noah's Ark.
Oh.
And the skeleton of the baby Jesus.
Oh.
All of these, of course, can be purchased in the museum gift shop.
Believe it, or else.
How do I look?
Dashing!
Oh!
Stupid girls.
Neat. I'll take this Jesus wiggle neck, sir.
All aboard, everyone.
Hi, I'm Orel.
Well, hello there, Orel. I'm Dr. Chosenberg.
Are you coming from Ripper Lee's too?
Nope. I just transferred buses from Otherton.
Is that a doctor star?
Well, actually, it's a Star of David. You see, it's a very important symbol of my faith.
Neat. I just learned that religious symbols should be treasured and not flushed down the toilet.
Good idea. I know I'd never feel safe traveling without my Star of David.
Gosh, Mr. Frigarelli doesn't have any symbols on his bus. Excuse me for a moment, Dr. Chosenberg.
Absolutely, Orel.
Watch yourself.
Here, Mr. Frigarelli. This ought to keep you safe.
Aw, isn't that cute?
And...
Holy!
Gosh. Yeah, I had a pretty rough season. I mean, I tried doing what you said, choking up on the back, but it didn't really seem to work. But I think with your help, in a few years, I can hit it over the fence.
Orel, what's going on?
Oh, hi, Dr. Chosenberg. Pretty great, huh?
Why hasn't my wound been bandaged or cleaned?
Because it's special, and it needs to be shared with everyone.
Well, what seems to be the problem here? Oh,
this wound must be dressed immediately, Doctor.
Yes, well, normally I'd say you were right, but this is a wonderful occasion.
Wonderful?
It's a miracle! The image of our Savior has appeared in the form of a wound on your body.
No, that was no miracle, Orel.
Sure it is. Look, it looks exactly like Jesus.
Carbon copy.
Of course it's a carbon copy. That thing lacerated my lower abdominal thoracic cavity.
Wow, you sure are smart.
Smart doesn't enter into this. I'm the head surgeon here and the only one legally qualified to deem this a miracle or not.
Oh!
Miracle!
I am a renowned surgeon, board certified by the BAA, and I can tell you that no medical credentials have any bearing on so-called acts of God.
Then how do you make excuses for when people die on you?
I take full responsibility.
What an ego.
Look, You are going to need a number 3 surgical kit and a slimline suture pack, stat.
You can't discard this holy image, Dr. Chosenberg. It's a sin.
Orel, it hurts.
Oh, well.
Look, a little pain never hurt anyone.
If you're not gonna treat this wound, I will.
Nighty nights, doctor.
Oh.
Hey, he looks like he's feeling better already.
Sure. In the hospital business, Orel, you'll find that all patients really need is to shut up.
Huh.
Jesus, heal me.
Ah, get her off me. I'm going to catch her tubercular infection. Orel, that lady needs help.
I know, and he's gonna help her.
You don't understand. She has tuberculosis, and he has streptococcal pneumonitis, and he has a menial infection, and he has gangrene. Mm-hmm. I could help him, Orel. I could help them all.
You are helping them by housing the symbol of our Lord. Thanks.
Someone, anyone, call the police.
I'm right here watching for line cutters. Hey, that's mine. Hey, that's mine, too. Huh? Well, now what are you doing?
What's wrong with you?
Toenail fungus.
Drink! No!
And my family.
Hey, everyone. No pushing, please.
Thank God.
Jews,
help me.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name already.
My pain. Oh, my pain just fell off a building. Oh, now it's on fire. Oh, my pain hurts. Oh, my pain is all right. Oh, my pain just got hit by a car. Oh, God, it hurts.
You see, Dr. Second Opinion Sin, he's contracted hepatitis, rickets, gonorrhea, and a dozen other diseases in less than 2 days.
Incredible.
Well, I think we should get him out of this hospital before he gets everybody sick.
But everybody will be healed with the divine wound.
Orel's right, but we've got to figure out a way to help him.
True. If he dies, the image goes with him.
Well, why doesn't he just kiss his own wound?
Just sit there and look pretty, Nurse Bendy.
I need medicine.
Here's all the medicine in the hospital.
Finally.
Get rid of it.
What?
Medicine's obsolete. Well, I'm gonna call it a day.
Me three.
Me two. Good night, Dr. Chosenberg. Good night, Jesus.
Orel, I am dying.
Oh, well, don't worry. The doctors are trying to help you, Dr. Chosenberg.
I know, and that's so nice of them, but I don't think what they have in mind will ever help me. Ever. I need real help, Orel. Please, just push that medicine tray over to me and I'll do the rest.
I can't. That'll mean I lost my faith. I'm sorry.
That's all for tonight, folks. Try and live through the night now. Orel, I thought you were going to pull some strings.
Dad, what do you do when something you want is good, but it's also kind of bad?
Ah, glad you asked, son. When I do something that I'm not comfortable with, I trick or fool myself into thinking it's right.
But isn't that hypocritical?
Some people may call it that, but I just like to call it lying to yourself.
Lying to yourself?
You betcha. One of the best survival tactics I know, kid.
Gee, thanks, Dad. Dr. Chosenberg? I was thinking, maybe if I put this Jesus figure close enough, it would help heal you.
Yeah, great.
Here, I'll put it on this tray.
Thanks.
I hope it helps.
Yeah, I'm sure it will. Thank you, Orel.
Jesus is pretty great, you know?
Yeah, I'm sure he is. This, that, this is good. Stir it up, this, that. Okay,
eyes are safe. Shucks. Okay. That. Okay, that's good, that's good. Here we go. It's be a little cold. Might sting a little, might sting. Let me know if it hurts. Oh. Yeah.
All right, let me at that wound.
Hey, the injury. It's looking better.
What? Oh, it's just a stupid, normal wound.
I guess the Jesus statue healed him.
What, this thing? Are you kidding me? Son, this was made like this on purpose. Only accidental holy images can heal people.
Oh. What are you looking for, Dad?
An accidental holy image, of course.
Dad, what are the chances of finding another?
Hello?
Look, Orel, a miracle. Those medicine bottles look just like Jesus. Oh, yeah. Oh, what a great savior. My dogs are feeling better already.
I guess Dr. Chosenberg accidentally arranged these bottles that way.
Hallelujah!